Hello everyone, we are group 25 and we have worked on a heat transfer problem that we frequently observe in our daily lives. Have you ever had a hot cup of tea in a paper cup? If yes, then you know how uncomfortable it is to hold these cups. Through this project, we aim to reduce this discomfort from identifying the problem to estimating the various modes of how heat transfer works in a hot paper cup, and then finally trying to estimate and increase the time that delays this discomfort. This is what we will take you through today. We worked on trying to minimize the discomfort caused by hot paper cups and used various methods to delay the rise in temperature of the outer surface of the cup. We all know that paper cups are used almost everywhere. From schoolgoers to office workers to travelers, everyone uses them. The paper cup market in India is of more than 200 billion units. So this problem is for Indian travelers, office workers, laborers, students, basically every price-conscious middle-class customer who enjoys a hot piping drink, but at the same time finds holding the hot paper cup very uncomfortable and might even spill it, which may cause burns, injuries, accidents, and it affects everyone. We attempted to minimize this discomfort by thermal insulation to delay the rise in temperature of the outer surface of the cup. You must have seen tea stalls across nooks and corners of the country. These paper cups are used widely over there. Now, let's zoom in into what actually happens in a paper cup. So, looking at the various modes of heat transfer from the paper cup, as we can see in the diagram, there is upper surface free convection between liquid of the cup and the surrounding air. There is upper surface radiation between the liquid of the cup and the surrounding air. And there is conduction through the cup. Coming to the technical problem statement, technically, the temperature of the hot beverage in the cup is around 80 to 85 degrees Celsius. And to comfortably hold it, we need to maintain it at around 40 degrees Celsius. We wanted to delay the rise in temperature of the outer surface such that it doesn't exceed a comfortable temperature of 40 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. Qualitative temperature profiles were estimated. So as there is convection between the wall and the air, there would be a convection over there, and between the cup wall, there would be conduction. Let's now dive deeper into the system. Analyzing the cup, we calculated the different terms of the energy equation and found that the convection term was contributing the most, that is around 56.7 watts, whereas the convection and radiation terms comparatively had very low values. Observing the problem, we found two time scales governing. The first time scale basically measures the time required for the heat to conduct from the inner surface to the outer surface of the cup, that is by conduction. And after this time, we start to feel the heat of the beverage on the outer surface of the cup. We approximated the terms of the thermal diffusion equation and found out the value of the time scale to be I square by alpha. And this came out to be the order of around 10 seconds. For the second time scale, the liquid in the cup is considered as the control volume. And then the energy equation is written. We find this time scale to be around 75 minutes, which is very large when compared to the first time scale. So also in this time scale, we considered the convection and neglected the radiation term between the liquid surface and the air, as the radiation rate was found to be very, very small when compared to the convection. As you can see, the second time scale was very large as compared to the first time scale. So for our time interval of interest, we took the temperature of the fluid to be constant. Now, Harshit will take over from here.
Yes. We find that the time required for the coffee to cool down is much larger than the time it requires for heat to diffuse through the thickness of the cup. So from here onwards, we can assume that the temperature of coffee is constant in the time interval of our interest. The time scale 1 being so low in comparison also signifies that conduction has a dominant contribution in heat loss. This fact was also visible from the rough values calculated in control volume analysis. So time scale one suggests that the time it will take for heat to diffuse through conduction is going to be L square by alpha. So our primary objective is to maximize this time to the extent possible. Now, in order to maximize time for a fixed thickness of cup, we'll try to minimize the value of thermal diffusivity alpha, that is K by rho Cp, where K is thermal conductivity, which we know is inversely proportional to resistance. So now we are going to look at a few possible cup designs and see which one of them does the job better. So case one. In the first case, we consider a three-layered system. The innermost layer is made up of vapor. The second layer has an alternating air chambers and vertical paper strips, as shown in film. The purpose of taking strips is to connect the other two layers. And the purpose of taking air chambers is to decrease the thermal conductivity configuration by introducing them. Also, the outermost layer is made up of paper. As for the resistance network, since the heat flows readily outwards dominantly, the three layers will be in series with each other. Also, the air chambers and the vertical air strips will be parallel to each other. Case two. For this case, we have two layers, the inner layer being that of paper, while the outer layer is made up of paper corrugations. Resistance network suggests that, as in case one, the two consecutive layers are in series with each other. To model this configuration, we approximated the air chambers in corrugation to be parallel to each other, and also approximated the chambers to be nearly equilateral triangles, as shown in figure. Okay, case three. For this case, we consider a three-layered system with a different material in each layer. We consider different combinations of material like polystyrene, polypropylene, paper, etc. And the resistance network suggests that in this case also, the three layers will be in series with each other. Now, for the three cases, the effective resistance expressions turn out to be as follows. Now we calculate K effective from the R effective expressions from here, and also calculate the expressions for rho effective and C effective in order to calculate alpha effective. Then we substitute that value of alpha effective to obtain the value of time scale. The value of time scale thus obtained in our three cases are as follows: 15 seconds, 43 seconds, and 50 seconds. Approach two. So from approach one, we got first order estimates for the required time. In approach two, we aim to obtain a more accurate solution for the required time by finding the 1D spatial temporal temperature variation of the curve. After that, we find the dimensionless conduction heat rate, that is Q star, and then use that to finally calculate the time estimate for heat to diffuse through the thickness of the curve. The governing equation for our approach would be dimensionless thermal diffusion equation, as shown here. Now, the initial and boundary conditions. The initial condition is given by the first equation here. It suggests that at time t is equal to zero, temperature at all x stars, that is in the entire cup, the temperature would be constant and equal to the initial temperature, which is the room temperature. The boundary conditions suggest that, the first equation suggests that on the inner side of the curve, the derivative of temperature would be constant, since the temperature itself is constant, being the temperature of coffee in the inner side. At the outer layer of cup and the outer side of cup, we can say that the conduction would be equal to the convection happening from the cup to the air, thus obtaining this expression after non-dimensionalizing. Now we attempt to solve this system of partial differential equation using the technique of separation of variables. We will then use the orthogonality property of eigenvalues to obtain the following solution. Theta as an will have some constants, and will be an infinite series. Also, the constants obtained would be directly related to the Biot number of our system. So now in our case, we assume that Fourier number is greater than 0.2, we can approximate the infinite series of our expression temperature to its first term only, which would be given like this. Now if we rearrange that, we obtain the following expression in terms of the real temperature, where T infinity is the temperature of coffee and Ti is the initial temperature of cup, that is the temperature of air. We then proceed to calculate the heat flux, which will be given by the gradient of temperature, and then we non-dimensionalize it. Now finally, in order to calculate the expressions for C1 and K1, we first proceed to calculate the Biot number. In order to do that, we use the Nusselt number correlation of free convection in case of a vertical plate with a laminar flow to find the convective heat transfer coefficient H. So for Rayleigh number around 10 to the power 6, Nusselt number correlation is like this. So from here, we can calculate the value of H to be 6.51. Now, from this value of H, we can calculate the Biot number, which we can use to calculate the value of C1 and K1. Substituting them in the expression for Q star will, and rearranging this expression, will finally give us the expression of T. Now, the time obtained for our cases, for the first case, which is the multi-layered system, is around 53.55 seconds. And for the case of vertical strips and air chambers, is around 18.24 seconds. This is a temperature profile for the entire cup at various time intervals. As we can see, the temperature of outer cup rises with time. This is the temperature profile for just the outer surface of cup at different time intervals. From this, we can see that the outer surface reaches the temperature of 40 degrees in about 15 seconds, while it reaches the coffee temperature at around 100 seconds. This chart here shows the time estimate for different material combinations in case 3 to reach 40 seconds. Okay, so now for the conclusion part, I would like to hand over to Prapti.
Okay, so let's see the conclusion and the results. Out of the three resistance network models that we analyzed, we found out that the corrugations case and the multiple layers case give some of the largest time scale values using the approach one, that is the L square by alpha effective approach. And some of the combinations of materials are given in the slide. And as we can see that the first combination gives the time scale value of around 74 seconds. Also, we see that using approach two, the time required for the outer surface temperature of the cup to reach 40 degrees Celsius is approximately 10 seconds for the multiple layers case. So what does this mean to the ultimate beneficiary? We can say that the corrugated cups provide a better grip and minimum contact to the hot surface because of their design. Also, corrugated cups are costlier and they can cater to the needs of tier 1 and tier 2 cities. Looking at the assumptions and the simplifications we made, we can see that from the timescale analysis, we assume that the temperature of the fluid is constant for our time interval of interest. But when the timescale 1 becomes of the order of 100 seconds, this assumption would no longer be valid. So by analyzing the various heat transfer modes, we neglected radiation. But if the person is drinking coffee or tea in a room which is has a temperature which is really relatively low, we cannot neglect the contributions from the radiative heat flux. Some of the improvements that can be made are as follows. Instead of a 1D transient model, we could use a 2D or a 3D transient model, and we could simulate it using some CFD software. This would give more accurate solutions. We can also use some better materials, but then the downside would be that the material is expensive. We can further work on the geometry, and by working on the geometry, reduce the thermal diffusivity alpha effective. And lastly, we can create airless chambers between the cup layers like that in a vacuum flask, which would drastically reduce the rate of heat transfer through the cup. Okay. We would like to thank everyone for watching this video.